What? I'm trying to get ready for my scene. I don't look like Voldo from Soul Calibur, do I? All right, cool. So let me do the scene real quick. Dear Challenger, it is I, the King of Despias, here to show you your demise. I don't sound like him from Powerpuff Girls either, do I?
What's going on with ya, big dog? And it is an amazing Wednesday. A workout Wednesday to be exact.
So I'm not even gonna lie to you. I have, of course, been working out at least 4 times a day. I just haven't gotten any footage for you.
A cool thing I want to point out is that I have been going to the gym with Sabrina, and it actually feels good to go along with somebody that you can actually, I don't know, have fun with. It's a totally different gym experience to go by yourself versus going with somebody, but I know one thing that definitely will work out for you. It's this Despia deck profile.
That's right, big dog. This Despia strategy hasn't even gotten to its beginning act, but I'm telling you, come 2022, boy, this will be the deck that everyone will be looking out for. I mean, people are already looking out for the deck. Alibers are $90 each. Allow me to explain why this strategy is justified at that particular price. But before I do, I actually do want to say one more thing. I've noticed that not a lot of people have been buying the merch. And part of it's my fault. I completely forgot to tell you. You can buy the merch at thecalieffect.com. I'll even hook you up for picking up some stuff just for this month, though. Don't say I didn't hook you up. Let's jump on in.
So like I said before, Despia are one of the decks that are primed to take over 2022, not only because of the Fallen Albash structure deck coming out, but because Burst of Destiny actually gave this deck some insane support. Not only in this build will I be going over what I feel is the most optimal way to play Despia and how it's played, I'll also be able to go over budget options for the players that maybe can't afford some of these expensive cards. Starting off with the Despia monsters, I run 3 copies of Aluber, 3 copies of Dramaturge, 1 copy of Ad Liptum, 3 copies of Despia Tragedy. Now, a lot of players will drop Ad Liptum from their deck, and I feel that if you can't afford DPE, then it's perfectly fine. But the thing that I really love about Ad Liptum is that it can special summon DPE from the graveyard, and when chain blocking correctly, or when you're discarding cards, it can also revive Despia monsters that have been discarded for the effects of your monsters like Fallen Albus. Moving forward for the branded cards that Aluber will search, 3 copies of Branded Opening, 3 copies of Branded in Red, and 2 copies of Despia Theater of the Branded. A lot of builds are playing 2 copies of Branded in Red, and the logic is because it's a great card, but it can be searched with your Aluber. The reason why I go ahead and play 3 copies is because I feel this is the best card in the deck. It is Warriors Returning Alive for you old school Yugi boomers, and also a Polymerization Nani. This card is completely ridiculous for the particular deck. And Theater is a very good card, but I don't think that you need it in 3s in this particular deck because we do have so many ways to search it. And once you activate it, it pretty much stays on the field. Branded Opening is Branded Opening, a free special summon from the deck, and you don't have to discard until on resolution, meaning that if your opponent uses cards like Ash Blossom or negates it with a Bet on Death Floor, you don't have to send from your hand to the graveyard, and you can also gain the effects of your Despian monsters like Tragedy, and if you decide to play Shadal cards, then your Shadal monster effects. Now, there is another engine that has crept back into the Despia strategy. I think it's going to take center stage. I run 2 copies of Fallen Albas, and it's complemented with 3 copies of Incredible Ecclesia. So this engine is, wow, it is completely ridiculous in this deck. So Despia has transformed into a better going second deck strictly because during your opponent's turn, you can special summon Incredible Ecclesia and put your opponent on, yo, I'm going to summon Albas from deck and I'm going to fuse with your board. On top of that, Incredible Ecclesia has another amazing effect that makes this card ridiculous. It's if a fusion monster is sent to your graveyard during the end phase, you can add her to your hand. It solves so many problems, needing to discard for Branded Opening or Fallen Albas, as well as giving you a recovery play to special summon more Albas from your deck to fuse with your opponent. This card is incredible. The only thing that I'm really sad that I can't take advantage of is that it's a tuner. I play no Secros in this deck. I will include budget options for this card because I do know it's expensive. We play a Destiny Hero package, and I really hate splashing Destiny Hero, Destroyer, Phoenix Enforcer, and everything, but I don't feel bad when this is a strategy that can take advantage of DPE, unlike most strategies. One copy of Denier, one copy of Celestial, and one copy of Dazzler, three Destiny Hero targets. Why? Because not only can you fusion summon for DPE twice, there is a combo where you don't even need your level 6 monster to make DPE within this deck. Next is three copies of Fusion Destiny, but if you guys cannot afford the Fusion Destiny engine as well as the Incredible Ecclesius, you can drop both of those for a Dogmatica engine. You can play one copy of Fleur de Lis, one copy of Maximus, one copy of Ecclesia. I would suggest a third copy of Fallen Albus because getting into this card is fairly good. Three copies of Nadir Servant to be able to take advantage of your extra deck cards a little better. And Dogmatica Counter allows you to be able to special summon Fallen Albaz from your graveyard to your side of the field or from your hand to be able to use the effect of Albaz to fuse. I felt that this card was way better than Dogmatica Punishment because Punishment is a good card if you don't need your extra deck. This is a deck that needs its extra deck. So you could play the Dogmatica engine if you guys cannot afford the DPE or Ecclesias. Another very expensive card for this deck is that I play three copies of Pot of Prosperity. This card is fairly good inside of this deck because you don't need your entire extra deck. And while you do need to dig into specific cards for this particular strategy, potentially your blowout or board breaking cards. Again, if you guys cannot afford Pot of Prosperity, I think that the fix is easy. You can drop all three Pot of Prosperities for one copy of Gold Sarcophagus. You can also drop another for a Foolish Burial, and then the third one for another Despia Theater. The reason why I suggest those two cards is because Foolish Burial and Gold Sarcophagus can banish or send to the graveyard your Despian Tragedy, which will trigger its effect to be able to search a Despia monster that you need. And then Despia Theater is just in case you needed an extra fusion card, because a lot of times you're using Prosperity to dig into that fusion card that you need. Moving forward for the going second cards or the board breaking cards, three copies of Nibiru. This card is amazing in here. The reason why is because this is a light monster, so at worst case scenario in the matchups where this card doesn't come up, like Outlitch or Altergeist or whatever, you can fuse with the rock and then just make the Despia monster that you need. In best case scenario, you get to use Nibiru. It doesn't matter what's the attack of the token you give your opponent, because you can always just use Fallen Albaz to fuse off the token into a particular card that you need. From there, it's three copies of Forbidden Chalice and three copies of Infinite Impermanence. I decided to go with this for my disruption cards because I want to be able to go second and pick apart my opponent's board, as opposed to playing hand traps that don't necessarily have a huge impact and will still leave my opponent with a board. But that is it for the monsters. The extra deck is, I mean, there are cards in the extra deck you can 100% take out, like, of course, if you don't or you can't afford the Destiny Hero cards, then you can 100% take out these. And even if you guys can't afford two DPE, it's perfectly fine. You can take out a DPE. I'm just running two DPE just in case, you know, I mean, it comes up sometimes. And Destiny Hero Dystopia is also another cool card that you can play. This is a card that you 100% can take out. But if you can gain the effect of Ablyptum to change the attack of all monsters on the field, then Dystopia does get its effect to be able to destroy. It also comes up in time to burn. This is literally, more often than not, some of my prosperity targets. So that's the reason why they're in there. Four are Fallen Albaz targets, two copies of Ash, one copy of Albion, one copy of Sprined, one copy of Brigand, and then one copy of Starving Venom. I didn't think that any of these came up more times than they should have. Titanclad being able to fuse off with a monster 2500 attack and more does come up twice oftentimes, but none of these cards seem to come up multiple times or times where I would need one, for the exception of Starving Venom. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. It really depends. It is your out to DPE after it's used its effect and hasn't destroyed itself. From there, we have two copies of Masquerade, the Blazing Dragon, and two copies of Despian Quaritus. A lot of times I go hard make Quaritus because I feel that this card is way more important than Masquerade. Don't get me wrong, the burn is pretty good, especially when you're going into time or going into the later stages of the game. But this card actually puts your opponent on, hey, you can't really beat him by battle. And if you do destroy him, that's perfectly fine. You can just special summon a Fallen Albaz from your deck to your side of the field, gain its effect, Alubric and Spellsummer from graveyard to negate a card, and on top of that, you can get your incredible Ecclesia to add from graveyard to hand, so I felt that this card was way more impactful. Link Karibo is ultra important for if you draw Despian, the level one Despian guy. I can't remember his name right now. Despia Tragedy plus Branded Fusion. It allows you to go into a two-card Quaritus or Masquerade, but some alternative cards that you guys could also play inside of your deck. You can play an additional Starving Venom, an additional Albion if Light is very prevalent inside of your deck. I never, ever made Proskynian. I don't play Super Polymerization in this deck, even though I think that this is probably one of the better decks that can take advantage of Super Polymerization. That's what Proskynian can do. If your opponent makes a board of a Light and the Dark monster, all you have to do is provide the Despia, and then there goes their board, and you get a really good card. And then Predaplant Vert Anaconda is a card that you don't necessarily need, but again, it can come up. But that is it for what could be the main board and the extra deck. Now I'm going to show you the combo that puts this deck over the top. So this is a two-card combo. The only thing you need is Fusion Destiny in your hand in either Despian Theater of the Branded or Brandon in Red. Either one of these plus Fusion Destiny is full combo, and it's kind of insane. What we're going to do is start off by using Fusion Destiny. And with Fusion Destiny, we will send Destiny Hero Denier from our decks to the graveyard, as well as Despian Tragedy. You didn't think you seen that coming, but we'll be able to Fusion Summon into our Destiny Hero Dangerous. And now we are locked from being able to Special Summon monsters except for Dark Hero for the rest of the turn. Use the effect of Despian Tragedy to be able to add from your deck to your hand the Aluber Jester of Despia, and then normal summon your Aluber to be able to add the opposite spell card from your deck to your hand. If you have Branded in red, search the theater. If you have the theater, search the Branded in red. From here, we will be able to use the effect of Destiny Hero Denier since we do control a Despia monster on our side of the field. And then we can follow up by activating Despia Theater to Branded. Look, we have one Destiny Hero monster and one level 6 or higher Destiny Hero monster. This does not have a restriction. You can actually fuse both of these monsters off into your Dark Hero monster, which just so happens to be Destiny Hero Phoenix Destroyer. Following up, you'll set the Branded in red, and on your opponent's turn, you can activate Branded in red, adding Despia Tragedy from your deck to your hand. But even more importantly, you can fuse with both Aluber and Despia Tragedy to be able to fusion summon into a Despia Quaritus. Trigger the effect of your Despia Tragedy right here, and you'll be able to add any Despia monster from your deck to your hand. My normal preference is going to be Aluber Jester of Despia. And that's exactly how two cards get you a destruction with Destiny Hero Phoenix Destroyer. It also gets you reduction of all your opponent's monsters, as well as the ultimate follow-up being able to special summon a Fallen Albaz from your deck to your side of the field, which can discard Aluber to fuse with your opponent's cards. And you also get an Aluber in hand if you don't go that route to be able to follow up with your play. So the next sequence is just so minuscule. It's so easy to do. It doesn't even set stage on what we're trying to do with the Despia deck. I'm actually going to add another sequence into it just to make it a little bit more interesting. I'm gonna add one random card. We're gonna make it a credible Ecclesia just to show you the power of Ecclesia too. What we're gonna do is normal summon Despia Tragedy, use it for a link into our Link Karibo, and then we'll activate Branded in red, adding the Despia Tragedy, and then we'll fusion summon. We'll fusion summon with both the Despian Tragedy and the Link Karibo into our Quaritus, triggering the effect of Despia Tragedy to be able to add Aluber Jester of Despia from our decks to our hand. From here, we can go ahead and normal summon Aluber. And in this particular sequence, I would actually add Branded Opening, not Branded in red, from my deck to my hand. And here's why. Let's say during my opponent's turn, or even we can do it right here, at any given opportunity, we can activate Branded in red, discarding the incredible Increasia to be able to special summon the Dramaturge of Despia from our decks to our side of the field, which could potentially negate a card. We can also just go ahead and discard said Ecclesia to be able to special summon from our decks to our side of the field a Aluber if our opponent does not follow up to this, to add another Branded in red, or even more importantly, to add a Despia Theater if this is the route that we are trying to follow up with, or again, even another Branded opening for an additional follow-up play. But my favorite thing about this particular sequence, no matter which card that we add, let's say that we added the Branded in red and decided to keep it in our hand. Even if our opponent breaks this particular board, we can activate Despia Quaritus as Chainlink 1, Alubar as Chainlink 2, so we'll be able to special summon Alubar to our side of the field and negate an opponent's monster's effect, and then we'll be able to special summon from our decks to our side of the field a Fallen Albatz. Potentially we're negating that monster that was going to stop us, discarding that Branded in red to fuse with both of those monsters into a monster of our choice. More often than not, it is going to be into our Ash Titanclad. And then on top of that, on end phase, we'll still be able to get Incredible Ecclesia's effect to hand. This is how this deck stays afloat, just generating advantage. Now, going back to my original combo, I'm actually going to take it one step further to show you the ultimate Despia board. There is no comedy or drama that will be able to surpass this particular board. The only thing it requires is the same two cards, either Fusion Destiny and Branded in Red, or your Despian Theater. And the only other thing you need to open pretty much is Alubar or any Despia monster like Dramaturge from your deck to your hand. Either of these will do, and you run quite a bit of them. What we're going to start off by doing is going through our regular combo. We're going to activate Fusion Destiny, sending Despia Tragedy and the Destiny Denier from our decks to our graveyards to be able to special summon our Destiny Hero Dangerous. That will trigger the effect of Despian Tragedy. If we have the Dramaturge, we'll add the Alubar. If we have the Alubar, we'll add the Dramaturge. And then we'll normal summon the Alubar to our side of the field to be able to add the Despia Theater of the Branded. From here, we'll activate the Destiny Theater of the Branded, special summon the Destiny Hero Denier, then use Despia Theater of the Branded to fuse with these two monsters into our DPE, and then we'll finish up by setting the Branded in red. On our opponent's turn, we'll activate Branded in red, adding Despia Tragedy from our decks to our hand, but more importantly, we'll fuse with both of these monsters to be able to make our Despian Quiridus. We'll trigger the effect of Despian Tragedy as Chainlink 1, Dramaturge as Chainlink 2. So now our opponent can't Ash Blossom that Tragedy. We'll be able to special summon to our side of the field the Dramaturge. And then from our decks to our hand, we can go ahead and add an Alubar Jester of Despia from our decks to our hand. This is the ultimate board for Despia, and the reason why is because there is just so much combo here. The first thing is that we can use Destiny Hero Phoenix to Destroyer to destroy our Alubar. This will set up if our Quiridus does get destroyed, we can still Chainlink Alubar to negate an opponent's card, Chainlink 2 to be able to special summon the Fallen Albatz, discard a card, and still be able to fuse. Another thing is that if any of our monsters do come to the side of the field, like let's say for example we destroy our DPE and then our DPE comes back to our side of the field, we can trigger the effect of Dramaturge to be able to negate a monster on the field. That is also really, really good. And then of course there's Alubar, Jester of the Despia himself. If our opponent can't crack this board, we do have game. We'll draw one random card for turn, and then we'll normal summon our Alubar Despia of Jester. We'll add a Branded opening from our decks to our hand, using the Branded opening to discard that card to be able to add a Despian Tragedy. But more importantly, we can go ahead and use Despia Theater to fuse the Tragedy and the Dramaturge into our second monster, which more often than not is going to be Masquerade, triggering Dramaturge to summon itself back to the side of the field, and Despian Tragedy to add another copy of Alubar from our decks to our hand. And that is all that I have for the next top meta deck in Despia. Of course, if you want to see more videos, you can go ahead and check out these. But of course, if you also want to see me on Twitch, well, I just so happen to be streaming today at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. But until then, I will catch you there, young peasant.